It's not often here at the World Cafe that we have a band that is associated with a teenage audience, not to say a boy band, in to join us. But Panic at the Disco are our guests today. Their latest album, Pretty Odd, garnered some out-of-character critical love when it came out in May. Remember, this is a young band whose focus has been primarily teen, and their new album, Pretty Odd, is painted with a broader musical brush and a healthy bit of Beatles dust. And it definitely works. We were happy to welcome Panic at the Disco in for an acoustic session that began with their song, Nine.
Acoustic Disco today is Panic at the Disco are playing live. You know, it's funny, so much of this new album, you know, people talk about how different sounding all the things are, and you know, the psychedelicized Panic at the Disco with all the Beatles influence, but so much of it is realized on guitars and the regular band. But then you get to have fun. You got to do the string parts and things. You got to go to Abbey Road, and was it specifically to do the strings there, or why did you go there?
Yeah, it was to do that and to mix the record as well. Peter Cobbin, who mixed the album, was the head mixer at Abbey Road, and so we went over there for about 10 days and mixed the record real fast, and it was a blast being over there.
You didn't do the thing in the street, did you?
We did, sort of.
Is there a photo of it? Is that weird?
A magazine from Spain, actually, when we were over there mixing the record, they asked us to do it. And we tried to do it, but the thing was, it was like 3 or 4 in the afternoon, so there were just cars racing by. So it wasn't really, you know,
we didn't get
even
it,
feasible.
Right,
yeah. So we just told them, yeah, it's too dangerous. We didn't want him to get ran over, so we just, you know.
But they used it anyway.
But they used it anyway, and the picture was, right. Whatever.
You know, the first album when you guys came out, you were labeled emo as an emo band, and you have to really define emo for me and for the listeners, because I'm not quite sure I get it. Does it mean not rock?
What
does
we'd love to know ourselves.
You know, we don't even really know. We know that we think that it's short for emotion, but. If no music's being written with any emotion, I don't know what the point is. I'm not really sure what it. We don't even know what it means.
Well, yeah, you could have been in the you know, the band with long song titles and you know, a lot of words lumped in category.
Yeah.
there is less sort of less of that on this album. Although there's a lot of real clever writing on here. Did you specifically scale that back a little bit, or did you think about that?
I didn't think about it that much, but I did notice that when we started this tour and we were playing some of the old songs and I tried to say the full song titles, I would forget them. So I think it was a good thing that we kind of condensed that aspect of things.
Panic at the Disco are playing live for us. We're hearing acoustic versions of tunes from Pretty Odd. And what's next?
That Green Gentleman?
Cool. You know what I'm seeing finishing up our session? Well, thank you all a whole lot for coming by. It's a real treat.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
Panic at the Disco, our guests, and we'll be back in a moment here on the World Cafe.